Main Activity is launched when you start the app. At the bottom of Main Activity, we have Placeholder Fragment. Placeholder Fragment was generated by the template we used when creating our project. A fragment is a modular container within your activity. In later lessons, we'll look at how to use multiple fragments in a single activity, and we'll actually explain why we're using them at all. But for now, our activity contains just this one fragment. So here in Placeholder Fragment is where we reference our UI layout resource, called Fragment Main. This XML file lives in the resources, res directory, of our project folder. You can see other kinds of resources here besides layouts, such as design assets, or drawables, or strings. When our activity runs, it creates this placeholder fragment, which then inflates the XML layout resource, converting everything in the XML file to a hierarchy of view objects in memory. By holding Control or Command, depending on your operating system, and clicking on this reference to Fragment Main, Android Studio will drop us right into the Visual Layout Editor. Once we're inside a layout XML file, we can switch between the Design tab, where we can drag and drop new UI elements and modify the layout visually, and the Text tab, where we can see and edit the XML that defines the layout and UI elements. All of the views we'll talk about here ultimately extend the View Base class. The template we used gives us a relative layout with some padding around the edges. We'll get into layout features like padding and margins later. Inside our relative layout is a single text view that says, "Hello World." Edit Text is a text entry field that is an editable version of text view. It has many options, such as whether it supports single or multi-line. There are several styled versions of Edit Text in the Text Field section of Android Studio, such as Name, Email, Phone, or Postal Address. Each one sets the soft keyboard into an appropriate entry mode. Image View displays the image defined in its source attribute. It has some really useful features, like zooming and cropping if the source image is too large, or has a different aspect ratio than the image view itself. A list view is a special kind of view that contains one or more views that are replicated to display sets of data. In this case, this single text view is used to display the weather information replicated throughout the list. We'll get into much more detail about list views later on.